Afternoon, guys. Same process as usual. Mics on either side. If you can please introduce yourself by name and organisation, and we'll set an embargo towards the end for half past 10 this evening.
Just a moment. Let me start today first, before the first question. On behalf of Manchester City family, my family, myself, my deepest condolence from Luis Enrique, from Luis Enrique Martinez and his wife Elena, of course, grandfather, grandmothers, and sister, Siria's sisters, and Pacho brother from her lost yesterday from Shana, the little daughter from 9 years old. So it's we knew it was not good, but always you dream everything is going well. I don't have words. I don't absolutely nothing to say because always you try to find the reason why it's the existence or the reason why this kind of thing has happened is not argument for a 9 years old, a little lovely daughter. Lost her life, so hopefully he can feel with Enrique and her family, from Manchester City myself especially, and my family myself, that we are here, and hopefully soon I can see him and tell him how I love him, not just him and his family. So, yeah, that's all.
Thank you, Pep. I'm sure we all share those sentiments as well. Well said.
Thank you.
To start today, I just want to ask you about Kyle Walker, if we can. It raised a few eyebrows, him not being in the England squad. Did it surprise you that he wasn't included by Gareth Southgate?
Well, it's a little bit in the first time, but of course, Kyle, the first one, and, and myself, I'm not involved, so respect the decision, and I think Kyle is coming back and stronger. So it's a decision, of course, I understand him, and support the manager of the national team, Gareth, and of course for Kyle.
Does it give you a positive for Manchester City, maybe, that he potentially gets some extra time to work here, some extra time to rest?
I'm pretty sure the players want to go to the national team and play with their own national teams. It's happened what happened, so adapt. And of course, we have time with the family now, the international break, but nothing, come back after and play as best as possible to come back for the national team.
VAR is about fine margins. As we know, City have been the receiving end of some very close calls. How do you think the system has worked so far?
I don't know. I'm not there. I'm not a technology guy, so I know exactly how it works. So we'll be better. So when the rules will be more clear, so everything is going to be better.
Ilkay Gundogan suggested it's taking the emotion away from playing the game. How do you think it could improve?
Yeah, reduce the time, you know, when his goal is allowed or disallowed. So this time, make it shorter and, you know, trust or let the referees make their own job. And after, when the exceptional situation, the VAR be involved. I said many times, well, one is a fair game. Justice will be, you know, to be out for a competition for a wrong decision, always is tough. So that's why the VAR is there. That is only the reason why, you know, to make it justice and to apply it. So maybe we need more time. But, you know, the people is going to do the best for solve it.
And just finally from me, I know we have spoken about this before, but the European transfer window and the English transfer window are still different. They close at different times. Do you think it would be better if the English transfer window closed at the same time we went back to the system it was before?
No. Is the Europe should be closed like English teams.
So that should change to join us effectively in the Premier
League? I support absolutely to finish the transfer the moment you start the Premier League or start to the season. So I'm pretty sure my colleagues from other countries work with the people that doesn't know stay or going to leave. In this kind of situation, you cannot prepare. And one player can play in the first fixture one team and the second fixture for another team. And so I'm pretty sure the best thing will be all leagues in Europe finish in the same day. Of course, here we start a little bit earlier than the other countries, but try to, you know, to make an agreement all the European leagues, you know, to finish in the same time. That will be the perfect situation. But I don't like to work three or four fixture games in when I have players, they did not know if one stay or going to leave. We start the Premier League knowing exactly which players are going to have for the, you know, until the rest of the season.
Pep, Damian Johnson from PLP. Can I get your reaction to the Champions League draw that was made yesterday?
Yeah, it's what it is. So, I didn't watch one single game this season against Shakhtar. With Paulo Fonseca, I know him quite well because we played last season, last two seasons. But now with the manager, I didn't watch it. I didn't watch one game at Dinamo Zagreb, and not even Atalanta. I have an info because the manager from Atalanta, I know him a little bit. He was incredible season last season, playing a different style than usual in Italy. But I didn't watch one game, so I cannot give an opinion. But last season was also, the people say, no, it's easy. We were lucky, but after the first game, we lost 1-2 at home. So it's okay, it's a draw. So sometimes it's this team, sometimes there are another teams. Let's try to, you know, to analyze them, to see them and talk what we have to do to qualify for the next stages.
How important is it to you that you win the Champions League during your time as Manchester City manager?
It's important, I know it's important, but if that happen, will be important too. So I will be the same guy, wake up in the morning, work a lot, going to sleep early as possible, eat good, take care of myself as best as possible, love the people I love. So it's not going to change my life. I'm going to do my best, but when I say thank you for everybody for my time here, it's not going to change my opinion about this title or not title. So at the end, I'm happy, or we are happy all together, what we have done so far, especially we came here to play in the way we want to play, we did it, and now is to maintain that level. And sometimes, you know, if we are good enough, we are going to fight until the end. If not, we're going to try next season.
And just finally from me, Brighton this weekend, fond memories of playing them in May and winning the title. Are they a changed team? Do you see a difference in the way they play?
Well, new manager. Of course, new manager. So new manager, there are some changes. So, for example, play five in the back. When last season, play four in the back with Swansea, Graham Potter. So they are more aggressive in terms of the high pressing. And they start quite well. And last game against Southampton, play more than 50, 55, 60 minutes, and again, 11 is not easy against Southampton. Nothing, prepare the game, try to win it.
Pep, can I just ask you about your squad in terms of injuries? How are Stones and Jesus?
They are much better. I don't know if we'll be able for tomorrow, but they are much, much better. If not, they are not ready for tomorrow for Norwich game, they will be ready.
After the break?
Yeah.
And just a word about Cancelo, because obviously he's yet to make his full debut, but with Kyle Walker obviously in that position and now with Kyle Walker not being in the England squad, do you have a decision to make whether or not it's right now to rest him, or would that be a double blow for him if he drops out?
First of all, so now when we come back for international break with Norwich, and after 3 days or 4 days we, you know, come back, regeneration day after, travel to Ukraine, and after 3 days later, we have game here, and after Carabao Cup, start the real season, you know, in terms of a lot of games. So, Joao, we are delighted what we have seen, but arrived late, so was not in the preseason. There are many things that Kyle knows completely well, because it's three seasons talking about that. And Joao start to, you know, to understand what to do, and now maybe tomorrow, or maybe, you know, when after international break, start to play. So, and understand he has to be ready like all his mates when we decide to play.
Pep, Fred Caldeira, Esporte Interativo Brasil. Coming back to Champions League, of course, when a competition starts, we try to find possible contenders for the title, and obviously, Man City, 2 times English champions, 4 titles last season. Do you think it's natural to look at Man City as one of the possible contenders for winning Champions League this season?
Yeah, I had this question for the same day I sit here. So same day when I arrived in my first season, people say, you have to win the Champions League because with Manuel or Mancini, they won the Premier League. You have to. They say, yeah, okay, we're going to try. So the same with the Premier League. So I know the reason why I will be judged. But also honest guy to myself, and maybe you don't realize, but I'm honest with myself. Like, there are incredible teams in Europe, as strong as we are. So, in one inch, one decision, one bad performance, one mistake, like we did, for example, in Bournemouth, in defensive areas, so you are out. So we know, we spoke many times about that. We are going to try. The important is being there in the draw, in the first, you know, box, and this is the draw. We are going to do our best. Start from our away game in Ukraine, and against Shakhtar, and we'll see the future, and how we arrive, if we are able to wait last 16 the way we arrive. So of course we want to win it. We dream on that and we work for that. But the same we work for the Premier League again, the Brighton game. And I'm not going to be distracted today, right now, here before lunch, talking about the Champions League, with my focus is just Brighton. Yes, I was focused in the afternoon, the draw, we'll together, we see it. Okay, that is the teams. Go home, Brighton. So I'm not going to be all my 10, 11 months here just thinking about all the Champions League, Champions League. Champions League is going to happen when we play in the Champions League. If done, we cannot do what we have done the last two seasons. So, but when you tell me, we're going to win the Champions League, yeah, the Premier League as well, and the Cup as well. So that is, we work.
Ian Parker from PA, up at the back, where Andy usually stands. In light of what's happened this week at Bury and Bolton, would you support increasing the solidarity payments that Premier League clubs play put down into the Football League?
For the Bury situation?
So clubs pay payments into the Football League, and the gentleman saying, would you say that Manchester City and Premier League clubs should pay more than they currently pay?
For the clubs that are below. Yeah, we did decide to do it, you know, together. It's okay, in Spain it happened, so before the leagues for the low divisions, but second one or third one, it was strong, and now it's MENA. So the big sharks eat the little ones. It's a problem, but if they decide, for all the CEOs of the clubs, support these teams in financial problems, I'm support. We support, give them the facilities, the training sessions, or the support you're gonna do it. Yeah, why not?
Hi, Pepe. Guillem Balaguer, Five Life. You had an interview in the summer in Spanish television in which you said that when you have the ball, when you attack, there is an area that it's impossible to defend. Would you try to explain what that is? I knew you were going to say that, so there's a second question related to that. Do you feel that because of the way teams are defending against you and they play in you, you have to trade new territory, you have to try new things that haven't been tried, and it's the only way to open them up and beat them?
I would say these areas is so difficult to defend, especially if you have incredible players. The moving that positions to make the difference. So that is not a fantasy, say that is indefendable. Indefendable because you imagine this player get the ball, make one dribbling on one shot and going to score a goal. But I think there are one or two areas that is so difficult to control. If they control these areas, they defend so, so, so deep. And it's difficult to make a counterattack in that situations. The question is about, of course. But we know each other, and when you do something, they open and react. And when they react, you have to react again. And when they control something, you have to adapt their movements to your movements, offensively, defensively. But that is what is nice, our job. It's a game. Like, you do something, you have to discover what you do with my players or my weapons against your weapons, how we, you know, we control it, we do it. It's simple, no more than that. Yeah, but it happened, yeah. For example, in the first season, few teams play five in the back. Since the second season, many, many teams play five in the back. In the first season, no striker defend our holding midfielder, and now most of the teams, their striker defend our holding midfielder. So more defensively than that is impossible. In the first season, I didn't remember years ago in the Premier League play five in the back. Everybody played 4-4-2, 4-4-2 channels, and now play many, many teams five in the back. Even more the teams play in diamond. Tottenham, for example, last game, Arsenal. So that is the way they set up. It's completely different the way you defend it, defend you attack. And that is what it is right now.
Buenas, Pep. I want to talk
I wanted to ask you about Aymeric Laporte, that probably he's not on all the covers of every newspaper like every day, but you have spoken about him as one of the best left centre-backs in Europe. Just how do you feel about his call-up for the French national team?
Well, for me, it's a mistake when I said he's one of the best. For me, he's the best left central defender right now in Europe. You cannot find it a guy who create defensively, offensively, amount of game in defensively, mentality, how he is. So I am incredibly grateful to Didi Shams and so happy for him because he deserved it to go there. Hopefully he can play good there and stay in the national team from France for a long time. And that's all. So all of us, we are so happy for him because he was looking for this call for a long time. And hopefully he can stay. Now it depends on him.